one of the countries that I grew up in was Niger. And so as I was growing up, I always wanted to go back to West Africa and help the people that had been so kind and wonderful to me as a child. As a master's student, I worked for Care International in Niger. And I realized that the health programs that people were doing in Niger weren't as effective as they could be because people weren't adapting health programs to the people's needs that they were working for. And so I decided to go back as a Fulbright scholar and gather a database of different ethnic groups and their health knowledge and behavior to help inform health programs. And while I was there, my research assistant was from a particular region called the Azawak. Wasn't a region I'd ever heard of before, even though I'd grown up in Niger. It's completely unknown to me. His family had to abandon this region back in 74 because of a large drought that killed off all his family's animals, and they could no longer survive there, so they abandoned the region. In any case, he begged me to go to his home region, and I did. And I had, at that point, I had worked in some of the poorest communities of Niger with Care International, and I thought I'd seen the worst suffering. I mean, we have to keep in mind that Niger is considered the poorest country in the world. And I thought I'd seen the worst suffering that I could possibly imagine seeing. Well, little did I know that I was going to be discovering, first of all, the most beautiful and kind people that I would ever meet, but also the worst suffering that I could not possibly imagine could exist on this planet Earth. And nobody is helping these people. Not a single humanitarian organization is helping this region that's the size of Florida, and the students will be able to tell you that in greater detail. And so I founded a program, Amman Imman, that's actually a part of an organization called the Friendship Caravan. So it is a nonprofit organization. It's an accredited nonprofit to help these people. And finally, I'm so pleased to be working with students. And with students, I feel not only am I raising money to help build wells and save lives in this region, because as you'll understand, the biggest need for these people, I mean, there's not a single permanent water source covering a territory that's as large as Florida. So, not only working with students is helping me bring water and save lives among people in Africa, but we're also educating, creating awareness, and opening the minds and hearts of the future leaders of our world. And that's such a beautiful thing for me. So the Oneness-Family School has undertaken this project, adopted this project, and as Andrew was saying, we hope that all the Montessori schools in America and that are represented here, and that, you know, even represented internationally, will do the same. Without further ado, I want to introduce Gabrielle, Nadia, and Jasmine to talk about the project.